When my daughter was born, she was really premature, and as a result, really sick. So it wasn't surprising that she spent nearly a month inside an incubator, basically a sterile box full of all sorts of high-tech equipment, so that medical experts could control her surroundings and monitor her every move. What was surprising was that, for a few hours every day, she was pulled out of that box, stripped of all her tubes and monitors, and swaddled onto the bare chest of a decidedly non-expert person. Hi, I'm David, this is Minute Earth, and, at least some of the time, that non-expert was me. Doctors call what I was doing kangaroo care, since the skin-to-skin contact it creates is a lot like the cozy confines of a kangaroo's pouch. At the time, I worried it was risky, since it took my baby away from that sterile box and all those monitoring devices. But I'm a data-driven science nerd, so you know I dug through the research, and I found that not only is kangaroo care not risky, it's actually one of the best things we can do to help babies born too early. There seem to be a couple major reasons for this. First, kangaroo care is a great way to keep a baby warm. Premature babies have less fat and more relative surface area than full-term babies, so they can't always keep their body temperature up. And it turns out that skin is way better at conducting heat than air is. Preemies that get skin-to-skin care are 67% less likely to suffer from hypothermia than those that don't. Second, during kangaroo care, bacteria from the parent's skin hop onto the baby, which sounds dangerous, but in order to develop a healthy immune system, a baby needs to be exposed to the right amount of bacteria early in life. Full-term babies get this exposure in their mom's womb during the last few months of pregnancy, but preemies miss out. By microdosing them with bacteria, kangaroo care can cut a preemie's chance of developing a major infection like sepsis in half. There also seems to be some additional advantage to being cuddled up with another human, rather than alone in a box, which maybe isn't all that surprising. We aren't sure exactly what the mechanism here is, though. Maybe it's the sound of a nearby heartbeat, or a reassuring smell, or the feeling of soft skin instead of hard plastic. But babies who get kangaroo care have lower heart rates, breathe more steadily, and get more sleep. Kangaroo care also benefits the kangaroos, parents in this scenario, which in turn benefits the babies. For whatever reason, people who do kangaroo care are more likely to breastfeed, which has all sorts of advantages for a baby's overall health. Parents who do kangaroo care are also more likely to say they feel bonded with their baby, to notice when something is wrong with their kiddo, and to feel more confident about taking care of their baby once they're back at home. Of course, this low-tech practice isn't the only intervention we have for babies born too early. Doctors also use CPAP machines to keep their lungs working, steroid injections to help their organs develop, and IV lines to get them the nutrients they need. But even considering all these higher-tech interventions, premature babies that get kangaroo care are 30% more likely to survive than babies that don't. And if you don't have access to those higher-tech interventions, then kangaroo care makes an even bigger difference for survival. My daughter is one of those lucky survivors. And my son, well, he was born full-term, so he didn't need the same intensive kangaroo care that she did. But our gratitude for the intervention made it extra fitting when we decided to name him Joey. You can probably tell I'm pretty passionate about life-saving interventions like kangaroo care, which is why I'm thrilled to say that this video was sponsored by GiveWell, an organization devoted to finding the absolute best ways for people to save lives around the world. GiveWell has now spent over 15 years researching charitable organizations and only directs funding to a few of the highest impact organizations they've found, like Helen Keller International, which distributes supplements to prevent vitamin A deficiency, and the Against Malaria Foundation, which distributes mosquito nets to prevent malaria. And recently, the Research Institute for Compassionate Economics, which trains hospital workers how to counsel parents of premature babies on, you guessed it, kangaroo care. You can donate to a fund directed to GiveWell's top charities on their website, where 100% of your donations go directly to the charities. On top of that, if you're a first-time donor, GiveWell will match your donation dollar for dollar up to $100. Go to givewell.org/minuteearth to donate. And to make sure that your donation gets matched, at checkout on the How Did You Hear About GiveWell question, click YouTube and then Minute Earth. Again, that's givewell.org/minuteearth.